Hello colleagues, we just received another request about the accuracy and it looks like it's worth drawing. So the request is the following. There is one mobile beacon, another mobile beacon, third mobile beacon, fourth mobile beacon, and the drone must be landing. As typically, it's pretty limited in terms of distance. So this is the configuration. So relatively small pad. And the drone must go up to 5 meters. So to be precise, it must be something like this and about this distance. So, and the question is, once again, how can we achieve the highest accuracy? How the mobile beacons, or how the station beacons must be placed, and what will be the inaccuracy in each direction. So, once again, let's draw. For example, this is the mobile beacon. Okay, now with these dimensions, it's maybe like 2 meters distance. In reality, it would be up to 5 meters. So when you have the base of 2 meters and 60 centimeters, then you will expect relatively small inaccuracy in this direction because you have a large base of 2 meters and large base, and this is 3D tracking, but now I'm kind of dissecting only one axis, so this will be small one, but this will be relatively large because the basis of 60 centimeters to 5 meters, so let's imagine this is 5 meters, would be almost 1 to 9. So it means that if you look from this perspective, okay, let's make it shorter. No. So this is 2 meters and this is 5. So, okay, let's back. So in this case, this will be precise, but there, and let's let it be X. And if this is just, so this is 2 meters and this is 0.6 meters. So in this case, this will be small, but this will be larger. How large, how much larger? Well, we already discussed in the previous video, very rough, not very scientific ratio, but would be plus minus 2 centimeters, our typical accuracy, multiplied by the ratio between the distances. In this case, the ratio would be 5 to 0.6. So it means that you shall expect about plus minus, okay, how many? 18 centimeters instead of 2 in this axis, when the base is small. In this, okay, 2 to 5, it could be doubling to plus minus 4 centimeters, but again, it's not so scientific, so it means that you shall expect spot more or less typical 2 centimeters, because 2 to 5 meters ratio is still a good ratio. This is already not good ratio, but this is on the distance. If you now think about their on another situation when the same but comes closer, so for example they're landing or catching the drone, okay, jumping, catching the drone on the distance of 1 meter, what would be the accuracy in this case? Well, the accuracy in this case will be almost ideal because you will have 2 meters and 1 meter. In this case, okay, in this case, you will have plus minus 2 centimeters because this is a nice triangle. And 60 centimeters will be also nice because it will be 60 base and 1 meter height. So you will also expect plus minus 2 centimeters. So your xy will be still very good, but we also have z. So it means that in this situation, xy will be perfect. So okay, y will be not okay, or at least significantly degraded. Z will be okay because the distance 5 meters is fine. No degradation. It's just z. So z will be okay. Y will be not okay, and x will be okay. In this x, so when the height is just 1 meter, so x okay, y okay, z okay. But what will happen when the drone will be landing? And when the drone will be landing, let's look at the same situation from the side. So this is our 2 meters, and 60 centimeters is in that direction, and the drone is landing. So the height will be whatever, 20 centimeters. In this case, x will be okay, very good. Y will be okay, but z will be terrible. Okay, let's put it bad. Why? No, because in this case, please check another video that we showed. In this case, those angles will be very uncomfortable, and the triangles will be very, very bad. So in this case, once again, x, y will be perfect, but z will be terrible. So it means that the simple answer, what is my accuracy, will depend on where exactly the mobile beacon is and what's your base. Will it be kind of comfortable geometry or not comfortable geometry? So, where it is? Okay, jump somewhere. Comfortable geometry is when your distances, let's say, not distorted, like 1, 2, 3 or something, would be fine. When distances are 1 to 10, like in this case, or like in this case, there will be a significant degradation in the corresponding axis. Which one? Well, it depends on which triangle is bad. So in this case, this is the bad triangle. In this case, is this bad triangle. So in this case, your y, x, so this will be your y, and this will be your x, and that will be your z. Depending on which triangle is uncomfortable, your different axis will be degraded. If anything is unclear, drop us a mail to info@marlomind.com and we will be happy to explain even further. Thank you very much.